Hello scholars, welcome back. As you know, we have already started a new unit in our previous video, that is Unit 5, Science and Technology. We have already completed few of its exercise in that video. Now today, we will do the rest of the exercises of Unit 5 in this video. So let's start with our exercise 26, Measure Me Right. Here, pictures of some measuring instruments are given below along with what they help us to measure. Pick up their names from the help box and write them below their picture. So as you can see, we have to write the name of these measuring instruments. So our first picture is, we use it to measure relative density of liquids. What is it? Yes, you are right. It is hydrometer. So please write here. Okay, now let's see our question number 2. This is used to measure the depth of the water in oceans. It is fathometer. Write its name here. Now, let's see our question number 3. This is used to measure curvature of a surface. It is spherometer. Write its name here. Okay, now we'll see our question number 4. This instrument is used to measure atmospheric pressure at a place. Yes, you are right. It is barometer. Now let's see our question number 5. This instrument is used to measure electrical potential differences between two points. It is voltmeter. Now let's see question number 6. This instrument is used to measure intensity of illumination. It is photometer. Now, let's see our question number 7. This instrument is used to detect and measure electric current. Do you know this? No. It is galvanometer. Write the name here. Now, let's see our question number 8. This instrument is used to measure the humidity in the air. Can you guess the name? Yes, you are absolutely right. It is hygrometer. Okay, now let's see our question number 9, the last one. This instrument is used to measure the intensity of the earthquakes. I guess you know the name. Yes, you are right. It is seismograph. So, with this we have completed this exercise. Now, let's move to our exercise number 27. So, here is our exercise number 27, viral diseases. A viral disease is a disease that is caused when the body is attacked by a virus. It is contagious and germs can easily spread from an infected person to a healthy person. So here, we have to name these viral diseases described in each of the following clues. So, let's read out the first one. This viral disease causes extreme inflammation of stomach and intestines. The patient suffers from severe abdominal cramps, diarrhea, and vomiting. Can you guess the name? No. It is gastroenteritis. It's a tough spelling, so please write it carefully. Now, let's see our question number 2. This disease usually occurs in children below 12 years of age. The body gets covered with a rash that has red spots and even blisters. There is great deal of itching and symptoms of flu. Can you guess the name? Yes, you are right. It is chickenpox. Please write the answer here. Now we will see our question number 3. A common viral infection that has symptoms such as high fever, body pains, headache, feeling of weakness and sore throat. It is influenza. Write the answer here. Now let's move to our question number 4. This viral disease causes swelling of the liver. A person who contracts it may get better or may have a chronic disease that will eventually cause liver failure. It is hepatitis. Now we'll see our question number 5. This is considered to be the most deadly viral disease as no remedy has been found for it yet. This disease attacks the human immune system, as a result of which the body becomes prone to infections. This is AIDS. Write the answer here. So, like this, we have completed exercise 27 also. Now we'll see our next exercise. So here is our last exercise of this unit, that is space vocabulary. Here we have to match the columns correctly. We have to read out the clues given in column A to find out the correct match from column B. So let's start with our first one. A heavenly body with a long tail. Yes, you are right. It is comet, and it is given in point number E in column B. So in front of first, we will write E. Now let's read out number 2. The place on the moon where Apollo 11 carrying Neil Armstrong landed. Do you know this? No. It is Sea of Tranquility, and the answer is given in option K. So in front of 2, we will write K. Now let's see number 3. Planets known as the gas giant. Which planet these are? These are Jupiter and Saturn. Jupiter and Saturn are known as gas giants. So in front of 3, we will write M. Now let's read out number 4. The largest and the most famous moon of the planet Saturn is? Yes, you are right. It is Titan, and it is given in point B. So in front of 4, write B. Now let's see question number 5. Main gases found on the sun. What are these? Yes, you are absolutely right. These are hydrogen and helium, and it is given in point H. So we'll write here H. Now let's see question number 6. Science that deals with the universe. What we call that science? It is called cosmology, and it is given in point G. Now let's read out number 7. Father of the Indian space program. Can you guess the name? Who is known as the father of Indian space program? Yes, you are absolutely right. He is Vikram Sarabhai, and it is given in point number L. Now let's move to question number 8. A star that explodes and become very luminous. It is called supernova, and the answer is given in point number C. So we'll write here C. Now let's see question number 9. The first artificial satellite of the world. Do you know this? Which is the first artificial satellite of the world? It is Sputnik, and it is given in point number N. Sputnik first. So we'll write here N. Now let's read out number 10. When the moon comes between the earth and the sun in a straight line, it is called? I guess you know the answer. Yes, you are right. It is solar eclipse. And our answer is given in point O. Now let's read out point number 11. The outermost part of the sun's atmosphere. The answer is corona. It is given in point number A. I know nowadays we all are very much familiar with this name, but here the outermost part of the sun's atmosphere is called corona. Yes, so right here A. Okay, now let's read out number 12. A small, very dense star which has spent its fuel. It is called white dwarf, and the answer is given in point number D. So please write D here. Okay, now let's read out number 13. Planets with no moons. Do you know the planets which do not have any moons? Yes, you are right. They are Mercury and Venus. They don't have any moons. So please write point F here. Okay, now let's read out number 14. The first Indian to go into space in the spaceship Soyuz T-11. Yes, he was Rakesh Sharma. And the answer is given in point, and the answer is given in option J. So please write J here. Now we'll see our last question of this match the following. First artificial satellite of India. Which is the first artificial satellite of India? It is Aryabhatta. And the answer is given in option I. So scholars, with this we have completed all the exercises of unit 5. Now I'm going to wind up this video, but make sure you all will do all these exercises in your book. Okay, so goodbye scholars, take care.